فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. We're in the sharh of أحاديث الصيام من كتاب بلوغ المرام. We were explaining the أحاديث of fasting in the book of Buluughul Maram, written by Al-Imam Hafiz Ibn Hajar Al-Asqalani rahimahullah. We are now on the third hadith in Kitab al-Siyam, ama hadith al-Siyam. The hadith, the chapter for it is تعليق الصوم والفطر بالرؤية, connecting fasting and breaking your fast by seeing and observing. عن ابن عمر رضي الله تعالى عنهما قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول إذا رأيتموه فصوموا وإذا رأيتموه فأفطروا فإن غم عليكم فاقدروا له. متفق عليه. ولمسلم فإن أغمي عليكم فاقدروا له 30 وللبخاري فأكمل العدة 30 وله في حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه فأكمل عدة الشعبان فأكمل عدة الشعبان فأكمل عدة الشعبان 30. This hadith, hadith ibn Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه, the first one of the two, is مخرج عند الشيخين إمام البخاري and Muslim both narrated it, as Hafiz ibn Hajar mentions, which is متفق عليه. And they both narrated it, Bukhari and Muslim, من حديث ابن شهاب الزهري عن سالم عن ابن عمر رضي الله تعالى عنهما. Bukhari narrated it in the book of fasting, بابو هل يقال رمضان أو شهر رمضان. الإمام مسلم in the fasting, الإمام النووي chapter in the chaptering of باب وجوب صوم رمضان لرؤية الهلال. And both of them, Bukhari and Muslim, as I said, they both narrated it من طريق ابن شهاب الزهري رحمه الله. And the wording that Hafiz ibn Hajar brought it, it is that which Shaykhain, Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim both mentioned. Imam al-Muslim also narrated this hadith in another riwayah, another turuq, another path, another way. من طريق عبيد الله عن نافع عن ابن عمر. But there's a slight ziyada at the beginning of that narration of Imam Muslim's one, which is فَإِنْ أُغْمِيَ عَلَيْكُمْ فَقْدُرُوا لَهُ 30. So as I said, Bukhari and Muslim both narrated the hadith. And they both narrated it مِنْ طَرِيقِ ابْنُ شِهِشَابِ مِنْ طَرِيقِ ابْنُ شِهَابِ الزُّهْرِي عَنْ سَالِمْ عَنْ ابْنُ عُمَرْ. Imam Muslim narrated this hadith from another طرق, which is the tariq of Ubaidullah and Nafi' and Ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, which has a ziyada, which has an additional point to it at the beginning of the narration, which is فَإِنُّهُمِي عَلَيْكُمْ فَقُدُرُوا لَهُ 30. Abu Dawood narrated this hadith as well, and he narrated it in Kitab al-Siyam بَابُ شَهْر يَكُونُ 29. But he narrated it from the tariqa of what? From the tariqa of Sulaiman ibn Dawood al-Ataki, and Hamad ibn Zayd, and Ayyub, and Nafi, and ibn Umar. And Nafi' in Sunan Abi Dawood, and Nafi' the student of Ibn Umar, who was the Mawla of Ibn Umar as well, Abu Dawood added an additional point to it, which is that Ibn Umar, فَكَانَ Ibn Umar إِذَا كَانَ الشَّعْبَانُ تِسْعًا وَعِشْرِينَ, if the month was 29, نُذِرَ لَهُ الْهِلَالِ, the crescent will be looked for. فَإِن رُؤِيَ فَذَاكَ, if it's seen, then good. وَإِن لَمْ يُرَى, and if it's not seen, وَلَمْ يَحُلَّ دُونَ مَنْظَرِهِ سَحَابٌ وَلَا قَتَرَةٌ, and there is no cloud nor dust, أَصْبَحَ مُفْطِرًا, Ibn Umar will stay without fasting. فَإِن حَالَ دُونَ مَنْظَرِهِ, but if there was between his seeing سَحَابٌ, a cloud, أَوْ قَتَرَةٌ, or a dust, أَصْبَحَ صَائِمًا, he will remain fasting. And the tariqah of Sulaiman ibn Dawood al-Ataki, who narrated from Hamad ibn Zaydin, who narrated from Ayyub, an Nafi' an ibn Umar, Sheikh al-Albani classified it to be sahih in the hadith number of 1902. Imam al-Bukhari narrated this hadith as well. He narrated it in Kitab al-Sawm, Babu, the chapter, قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا رأيتم الهلال فصوموه. But this time Bukhari brought it from what? من طريق مالك عن عبد الله بن دينار عن ابن عمر. And also Bukhari has a زيادة in its addition at the beginning. فإن غم عليكم فأكملوا العدة 30. That is all of that which relates to the hadith of Ibn Umar, the first one. The second hadith is hadith Abu Huraira. The hadith of Abu Huraira, Bukhari and Muslim both narrated it. Bukhari narrated it, and Imam Muslim rahimahullah narrated it. Both of them, they narrated it from min tariq Shu'bah ibn Hajjaj, who narrated from Muhammad ibn Ziyad, who narrated from Abu Huraira radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, which his wording is صوموا لرؤيته وأفطروا لرؤيته فإن غبي عليكم فأكملوا عدة شعبان ثلاثين. That's the warning of Imam al-Bukhari. And Imam Muslim, he says فإن غمي عليكم الشهر فعدوا ثلاثين. Here is an issue that occurred from Hafiz ibn Hajar, which is فإن غم عليكم فقدروا له. He said متفق عليه ولمسلم فإن أغمي عليكم فقدروا له ثلاثين وللبخاري فأكملوا العدة ثلاثين. And then he said وله في حديث أبي هريرة. So Imam Hafiz ibn Hajar, he said وله في حديث أبي هريرة. This وله, that وله is, it's a tricky point, or it's a problem, because موهما أنه إفراد البخاري. It looks as though that it is only from the narration of Imam al-Bukhari, because that was the last mention. وَلِلْبُخَارِيُ فَأَكْمِلُ الْعِدَّةَ ثَلَاثِينَ وَلَهُ أَيْ وَلَهُ أَيْ وَلِلْبُخَارِي. And the reason why Hafiz ibn Hajar fell into this issue, this problem, is because he followed the ghazu of Sahib al-Muharrar, Ibn Abd al-Hadi. He followed this in Ibn Abd al-Hadi. He followed this in what? Ibn Abd al-Hadi. And what has become clear to us, as I just previously mentioned, that this hadith is from what? أنه من الحديث المتفق عليه. It's that Bukhari and Muslim both narrated it. But the wording is the wording of Imam al-Bukhari, and that is what it seems like Hafiz ibn Hajar is trying to say, that the hadith of Abu Huraira is the wording of Bukhari. But what Hafiz ibn Hajar should have done, Why are we saying that he should have done this? Because this is his norms. فَكَانَ الْأَوْلَى بِهِ كَعَادَتِهِ أَنْ يَقُولَ مُتَّفَقٌ عَلَيْهِ. It was more befitting for him to say مُتَّفَقٌ عَلَيْهِ and then say وَهَذَا لَفْظُ الْبُخَارِيُّ. And he should have then said this is the wording of Bukhari, to show that the hadith is narrated by Bukhari and Muslim, but the wording is the only wording of Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. That is what relates to al-kalamu ala al-hadithi. That was talking about the hadith in terms of what? Ala al-hadithayni, speaking about both of the hadith from the angle of what? Riwayatan. We spoke about it in terms of its riwayah, its narration and whatnot. Now we're going to go into the diraya and the understanding of the hadith. The first thing we need to understand is there's a gharibul hadith wa mufradati. This is something we said we're going to always do. The strange wordings that are in the hadith and the terminologies that are used. If we look at the wording of the hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَصُومُوا وَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَأَفْطِرُوا. So we see that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used in the hadith of Umar, two places he used the what? He used رَأَيْتُمُوهُ two times. في موضعين من حديث ابن عمر. And if you look at that, then this is a ضمير الغائب. It's a pronoun for an absent. It's a pronoun for an absent. And it doesn't have دون أن يكون له اسم ظاهر يرجع إليه. And there is no proper noun in which this pronoun goes back to. So there is no name that was mentioned in which this pronoun goes back to. So this is gharib. This is ishkal now. And this is, if you go back to all the hadiths, the kutub which they are narrated, you'll see that that's how the wording is. The meaning is clear because two ways tells us what this pronoun goes back to. Two things are telling us it. There are two things that tell us it. The first thing that tells us it is مَفْهُومُ مِنَ السِّيَاقِ. From the context it becomes clear to us. From the context, it's clear that this is Ramadan that's been spoken about. So then it becomes clear to us that the إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ is referring to the crescent, the hilal, the crescent. That's in terms of its meaning. In terms of its narration, there is a clear narration that mentions the hilal, which in Imam Muslim narrated it. And also Bukhari rahimahullah did as well. Imam al-Bukhari narrated min Yahya ibn Bukhayrin al-Layth al-Uqayl al-Ibn Shihabin bihi. And also Bukhari Muslim rahimahullah narrated it, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُ الْهِلَالَ فَصُومُوا وَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَأَفْطِرُوا. So the hilal was brought in that narration. But if you see the hilal. So two things tell us where the pronoun goes back to. One is the meaning, and one is that there are other external narrations that have come in order to support it, to tell us that which is in the hadith or that which is meant by it is that it is the hilal. Now look at the first إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ and the second إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ. The first إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ is referring to the hilal of Ramadan, the crescent of Ramadan. And the second one, which is وَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ is referring to the hilal shawwal, the moon of shawwal. So the first one is called hilal Ramadan, it's talking about the crescent of Ramadan, and the second one is talking about the crescent of shawwal. And that is why the hadith says to us, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ, if you see the moon of Ramadan, or the crescent of Ramadan, فَصُومُوا fast. وَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ, and if you see the hilal of Sha'ban, Shawwal, فَأَفْطِرُوا, break your fasting. The second one is, وَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ هِلَالُ شَوَّال فَأَفْطِرُوا, break your fasting. Is that clear? That's the first point. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَإِنْ غُمَّ, فَإِنْ غُمَّ. And some of the riwayat Ibn Umar, and if you guys remember properly, which is Sahih Muslim, and Muslim brings this one, فَإِنْ غُمِّيَ, and another riwayah which was فَإِنْ غَبِيَ, both narrations have come. But we want to first know what is فَإِنْ غُمَّ. First of all, the way we read it is فَإِنْ غُمَّ, which is ضَمُّ الْمُعْجَمَةِ وَتَشْدِيدُ الْمِيمِ. Some narrations it says أُغْمِيَ, which is the hadith of Umar. Abu Huraira says, his riwayah says, غُمِّيَ. So we have غُمَّ, we have أُغْمِيَ, and we have غُمِّي. Are you with me? And all of those meanings are the same as Imam Al-Raghib Al-Asfahani, however you want to say it, He says in his kitab An-Nihaya fi gharib al-hadith. He says yuqalu ghumma alayna al-hilalu kama yuqalu ughmi alayna al-hilalu wa ghummiya idha hala duna ru'yatihi ghaibun aw qataratun. So An-Nihaya Ibn Athir rahimahullah, he mentions and he tells us that ghumma, ughmiya, wa ghummiya, all of them they mean the same. He says all of them are what? They mean إِذَا حَالَ دُونَ رُؤْيَتِهِ غَيْمٌ أَوْ قَتَرَةٌ. It is if there's a cloud or if there is dust and smoke that gets between you and sighting the moon or the crescent. Bukhari's wording is what? فَإِنْ غَبِيَ. فَإِنْ غَبِيَ. فَإِنْ غَبِيَ is what? بِفَتْحِ الْغَيْنِ الْمُعْجَمَ وَكَسْرِ الْبَاءِ الْمُوَحَّدَةِ. And it comes from the word مَأْخُوذٌ مِنَ الْغَبَاوَةِ وعدم وهي وهي عدم الفطنة وهي استعارة لخفاء الهلال. It is when something is hidden from you. As النهاية في غريب الحديث ابن أثير says فإن غبيا أي خفيا, if it gets hidden from you. So the word أغمية, غمة, غمية, غبية, all of them they mean the same. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said this other strange word is فَقْدِرُوا لَهُ. You can say, you can say فَقْدُرُوا لَهُ. So both ways are allowed to be said. Which one is the eloquent one way of saying it? It's eloquent to say بِكَسْرِ الدَّالِ. فَقْدِرُوا is more eloquent. To say فَقْدِرُوا لَهُ is more eloquent. But it's permissible for you to say فَقْدُرُوا, فَقْدُرُوا. You can say both ways. And we've mentioned in the previous hadith that the ulama have two interpretations regarding this. فَقْدُرُوا لَهُ. And that the strongest opinion here is what? مَعَلَيْهِ الْجُمْهُورِ, that which the majority of the scholars are upon. خِلَافًا لِلْمَشْهُورِ مِنْ مَذْهَبِ الْحَنَابِلَةِ. In opposition to that which is very well known in the Hanbali madhab. And that is what? That the word اِقْدُرُوا لَهُ means اِحْسِبُوا لَهُ, account for it. مِنْ الْحِسَابِ وَالتَّقْدِيرِ, account it and estimate it. والمعنى التقدير له بإكمال العدد العددي. But the correct meaning is that we complete it by 30 days تماما. And Hafiz ibn Hajar, he brought another group of people who tried to get from فقدروا له أما فقدروا له. Imam Hafiz ibn Hajar in his Fathul Bari, he mentions that Abu al-Abbas ibn al-Sarraj, who's from the Shafi'iyya, and Mutarrif ibn Abdullah al-Shakhir from the Tabi'een, and Ibn Qutaybah from the Muhaddithin, they all said there a third interpretation, which is that بحساب المنازل, that you do the astronomical, that is done. Ibn Abdul Bar, rahimahullah, he says, as for Mutarraf ibn Abdullah, he said, لا يصح. There's no authentic chain of narration from him. As for Ibn Qutaybah, Ibn Abd al-Barr said, فَلَيْسَ مِمْ هُوَ مِمَّنْ Ibn Qutaybah, he is not from those people who is relied on this in this regard. Now we need to look at five things relating to this hadith now. Five mas'ala, five fiqh issues. We've spoken about the gharib al-hadith. First we finished, we spoke about Hadith ibn Haythu al-Riwayah, from the angle of Riwayah. We spoken about it min Haythu al-Dirayah. But we spoke about min Haythu al-Dirayah one point, which is gharibu al-hadith wa mufradatu. We spoke about the strange words that are in there and the meanings that those words carry. Min Haythu al-Dirayah, we're going to move on to the next one, which is fiqh al-hadithayni wa masailihuma. We're going to now look at both of the hadiths and the matters that are in it. And there are five things that we take from it, inshallah ta'ala. Five fiqh and five masail that we're going to take from this hadith. Mas'alatul ula, the first mas'ala, or the first fiqh that we take from this hadith is what? Both of the narrations. That it's ala wujubi ikmali sha'ban 30 yawman. That sha'ban, we have to complete it 30 days. When lakin fi hal istitar al-hilal, when the crescent and the moon is hidden from us, either by the cloud or by dust, or anything other than that. So if a person doesn't know, هل أهل هلال رمضان, has the sighting of Ramadan taken place or not? Or has it been seen? And the reason why is because of the fact that the eyes can't see it. No one knows if Ramadan has entered, whether the moon has actually been is out there. The reason is because بسبب انعدام الرؤية والإبصار, the sighting of the moon is hard, and the seeing is hard. This is now what? فهو يوم يشك. It's a day which is doubted. هل هو من رمضان? Is it from Ramadan? Have we entered into Ramadan? أم أنه ما يزال من شعبان? Or are we still in شعبان? Are we still continuously in شعبان? There's that doubt. And this hadith goes in accordance to the previous hadith that we touched on, which is النهي عن صيام يوم الشك, the prohibition of fasting the day of doubt. Rather, not only does it go hand in hand with that hadith, but it also goes hand in hand with two qa'idas which are known. بل يوافق القاعدتين المعروفتين. Rather, it goes in accordance to the two well-known principles, which the first one of it is اليقين لا يزول بالشك أما لا يزال بالشك. A certainty is not removed with doubt. And the second qa'ida, which is al-aslu biqa ما كان على ما كان. That the original essence is that everything, it is left as it was. In its original essence, that it should be left how it is. The asal, which here we are certain about, is what? That Sha'ban is in. The asal is that Sha'ban was something we were in. We were in Sha'ban, there's no doubt about that. But the doubt is, has Sha'ban gone and has Ramadan entered? So the doubting here is what? دخول رمضان مشكوك فيه. The entering of Ramadan is doubtful. Then the qa'ida was what? اليقين, the certainty of Sha'ban's existence, cannot be removed with the doubt of Ramadan. And an example for that is, لو كان الإنسان طاهرا, a person was upon purity, وشك في الحدث, and he doubts impurity. What's the ruling in this? The ruling is فإنه يبقى على طهارته, that the person remains upon his purity, and that he stays upon the certainty, and he does not remove onto the what? ولا ينتقل عن الطهارة بحدث مشكوك فيه, and that he doesn't leave the certainty, which is the purity, to the doubt, which is the impurity. You don't do that. And why is that? And this religion, my brothers, it shows us من سماحة هذا الدين how simple and how easy our religion here is. Our religion is a religion of ease and simplicity. Hafiz ibn Hajar, rahimahullah, in Kitab Fath al-Bari, the fourth volume, page 122. The page what? Page 122, Hafiz ibn Hajar in Fath al-Bari, he brings the statement of Ibn Abdul Hadi in his tanqih. In the tanqih by Ibn Abdul Hadi, rahimahullah ta'ala. That Ibn Abdul Hadi said, Hafiz ibn Hajar is quoted Ibn Abdul Hadi. That Ibn Abdul Hadi said, الذي دلت عليه الأحاديث, that which the hadith have shown, وهو مقتضى القواعد, قواعد, وهو مقتضى القواعد, وهو مقتضى القواعد, and it is also in accordance to the principles is أنه أي شهر, that any month, غم, that there is a barrier between you and seeing the moon, أكمل ثلاثين, you complete it to 30. This is the what? الذي دلت عليه الأحاديث, the hadith have shown this, and وهو مقتضى القواعد, and it is in accordance to the principles. We mentioned two of those قواعد, right? which is al-yaqeenu, la yazulu bil-shak, ama la yuzalu bil-shak, and al-aslu biqa' ma kana ala ma kan. So here, Ibn Abdul Hadi's statement is beneficial. You know why? Because he's saying this is not only for Ramadan and Sha'ban. No. He's saying, أَنَّهُ أَيَّ شَهْرٍ, it is any month. غُمَّ, which there is no ability to see it, أُكْمِلَ ثَلَاثِينَ, 30 days are finished. سَوَاءٌ فِي ذَلِكَ شَعْبَانٌ وَرَمَضَانٌ. He said, whether that is in the Sha'ban and Ramadan, or whether it is other than it. This is a fiqh of that great noble scholar Ibn Abdul Hadi rahimahullah ta'ala. The second mas'ala and the second fiqh that we take from the hadith. The second fiqh that we take from the hadith is what? أن العبرة أم أن المعتبرة في الصيام, the thing that is taken into consideration when it comes to fasting, and when it comes to breaking the fast, is two things. There are two things to take into consideration to say that the Shahr Ramadan has entered. And there are also two things which we base our rulings on to say that the month of Ramadan has now gone. So it's only two things. لا ثالث لهما, there's not a third thing. The first one is what? رؤية الهلال, the sighting of the moon. So we sight the moon for the entering of Ramadan, and we sight the moon for the leaving of Ramadan and the entering of Shawwal, based on this hadith, in which the Prophet ﷺ said, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَصُومُوا وَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَأَفْطِرُوا فَلَا يَجُوزُ. Then based on this hadith then, it is not permissible to fast before sighting the moon for Ramadan. As it's also not permissible what? كَمَا لَا يَجُوزُ الْإِفْطَارُ, the same way it is not permissible to stop fasting or to consider the ending of Ramadan to come without sighting the moon of Shawwal. And inshallah ta'ala, there's no problem if the people use telescopes, if they use those things, because those are all what? لأن في الحقيقة أمور مساعدة للعين, because those things are only things that help the eye in getting things closer to you and to clarify it for you. And this is the opinion of السماحة الوالد الشيخ عبد العزيز بن باز عليه رحمة الله in his مجموع الفتاوى. Ibn Baz took that opinion that it's no problem if the people use telescopes. He said that on his 15th volume, page 70. Because the Shaykh rahimahullah, he said that all this is reality is musa'ada. It's just help and aiding your eyes. But he said it is not the umda. The umda means what? It's not the full reliance. The full reliance is in what? عَلَى رُؤْيَةِ الْعَيْنِ, the seeing of the eye. So the second way in which Ramadan is established, or the leaving of Ramadan is established, is by completing 30 days إِذَا لَمْ يُرَى الْهِلَالِ. That's if the first one wasn't done. The first one, which is the رُؤْيَةُ الْهِلَالِ, which is the sighting of the moon, doesn't happen, then we move on to the second option, which is we will have to complete Ramadan 30 days and then move on to Shawwal. Or the month before Ramadan, which is Sha'ban, we'll have to finish Sha'ban on 30 days since we didn't see the Hilal. So this is the second method. Where's the evidence for that? Then it's in the hadith, فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ فَأَكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةَ ثَلَاثِينَ, which is the next part of the hadith. فَإِنْ أُغْمِيَ, some riwayat said it, أَمَا فَإِنْ غُمَّ, and فَإِنْ غُمِّيَ, we said all of those are the same, عليكم فقدروا له ثلاثين أما فأكمل العدة thalathina. How many days do you complete it to? 30. You complete it on what? On 30. ولذلك الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية عليه رحمة الله. Then those are the two ways. First of all, before I say Ibn Taymiyyah's statement, those are the two ways which Ramadan's entering and Ramadan's leaving is done on. And that's not only Ramadan. As we brought the statement of Ibn Abdul Hadi, it's not only Ramadan. This is for who? This is for every single month. That the sighting of the moon is done. If it's not seen, then it is completed to 30 days. Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah said a statement which deserves to be read, inshallah ta'ala, in his 25th volume, page 132. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he says, we know out of necessity from the religion of Islam that rulings are based on the sighting of the moon. Like fasting. Like hajj. Like iddah. The woman's menstruation at iddah. And also like the ilam. Or other than that, in terms of ahkam that are collected to the moon and the sighting of the moon. So hajj is based upon the moon. The iddah is based upon the moon. Ramadan is based upon the moon. Ila is based upon the moon. All of these are what? Are they? They are based upon the? Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah then says, بِخَبَرِ الْحَاسِبِ أَنَّوْ يُرَى أَوْ لَا يُرَى لَا يَجُوزِ. And to base it on the what? To base it on which issue we're going to come to later, inshallah ta'ala, which is the issue of using the method that people try to do, which is the third. They try to invent a third way, which is they want to use the astronomy. They want to use these degrees. In what? Establishing it. The hadith clearly says to us what? One of two. إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ. If you see it. So رُؤْيَةُ الْعَيْنِ is spoken about here. The eyesight has seen it. Or the hadith says, فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ فَأَكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةَ 30. Then we complete it to 30. Then we have no other choice other than seeing it or completing on the 30 days. This issue of what? The حساب الفلكي, we're going to, inshallah ta'ala, prove that that is incorrect. The third mas'ala that we take from this hadith, or the third fiqh we take from this hadith is, before I move on to the third one, there's an issue which I have to mention, which refutes this concept of the usage of the astronomy, which is the hadith narrated by a Bukhari and Muslim. من حديث عبد الله بن عمر, which is that the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, إِنَّا أُمَّةٌ أُمِّيَّةٌ. We are a nation who are illiterate. لَا نَكْتُبْ. We don't write. And وَلَا نَحْسَبْ. And we don't do حِسَاب, which is astronomy. We don't use the falak. We don't do that, the Prophet said. الشَّهْرُ هَكَذَا وَهَكَذَا وَهَكَذَا. The Prophet said, the month is like that, and like that, and like that. وَعَقَدَ الْإِبْهَامُ ثُمَّ الثَّالِثَ. The Prophet ﷺ, he took the finger and he connected those two, عليه الصلاة والسلام, trying to say what? 29. This is one of the ways that the Arabs would say 29. وَالشَّهْرُ هَكَذَا وَهَكَذَا وَهَكَذَا. And the Prophet ﷺ said, the month is this, and this, and this, meaning referring to as 30. So it's either 29 or 30 for us Arabs. We don't use this astronomy. We don't use astronomy. So the hadith of Prophet ﷺ says it clearly. Hafidh ibn Hajar in Fath al-Bari, in Fath al-Bari, he says a very powerful statement. He says, فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ فَأَكْمِلُوا الْعِدَّةَ 30. He says, if it's hidden from you, فَإِنْ غُمَّ عَلَيْكُمْ, if it's hidden from you, then complete it to 30. Then complete it to what? 30. Ibn Hajar said, وَلَمْ يَقُلْ. He said that the Prophet didn't say, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلِ الْحِسَابِ. Ask the people of astronomy. The Prophet didn't say that. والحكمة في كون العدد عند الإغماء يستوي فيه المكلفون فيرتفع الاختلاف والنزاع عنهم. Al-Hafidh ibn Hajar mentions the wisdom behind that. He says the wisdom in that is what? That the figure, when it's hidden, everybody is the same in it. The mukallafun are all the same in it. So فَيَرْتَفْعُ الْإِخْتِلَافُ. The dispute is lifted. وَالنِّزَاعُ عَنْهُمْ. And disputations. If you guys couldn't see it, the Sharia took it from all of you guys. And it made it into the 30, so there's no disputes or argumentations in that particular matter. So inshallah ta'ala, go to Majmu' al-Fatawa, read the 25th volume, page 113, 132 and 146, and 166 and 174, by Ibn Taymiyyah, his Majmu' al-Fatawa. Also read Fath al-Bari, the 4th volume, page 127. Also read Majmu' al-Fatawa Ibn Baz, the 15th volume, page 109. You'll find more explanation there, inshallah ta'ala. The third mas'ala, I mean the third fiqh that we take from this hadith is what? هَلْ يُعْتَبَرُ فِي الرُّؤْيَةِ اِخْتِلَافُ مَطَالِعِ الْأَهْلِ أَمْ أَنَّهُ إِذَا رُؤْيَ فِي بَلَدٍ لَزِمَ النَّاسُ كُلُّهُمُ الصَّوْمِ. The issue here is it taken into consideration the sighting when there is a difference of region? The region are different. Or if it's seen in a particular place, then everyone else has to fast. If it's seen in one land, does that mean every single place in the world has to fast? Before I mention the khilaf, I want to explain to you guys how the khilaf occurred. Before I mention to you the difference of opinions there are, I need to explain to you how it occurred. Because we are what people who are students of knowledge, and we need to understand how the disputations and the argumentations of the ulama came into place. If we go back to the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَصُومُوا وَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَأَفْطِرُوا. Here we find that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ, if you see it, رَأَيْتُمُوهُ. So what's the condition here? اشتراط الرؤية. The seeing is conditioned. Also, that's one. إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ, the first thing we took from it is what? That the seeing is a condition. The second thing that the hadith also mentioned, what? Also the point that we also take from the hadith is what? That the people all have to see it. Because the hadith says, فَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ, it's plural. If you all see it. اشْتِرَاطُ الرُّؤْيَةِ عُمُومِ النَّاسِ لَهُ. That is conditioning to be cited by every single person. So it's saying, as though it's saying, فَإِذَا رَأَهُ النَّاسُ, if the people see it, جَمِيعًا, all of them, وَجَبَ الصَّوْمُ, that the fasting is obligatory, and if everybody does not see it, then there is no fasting obligatory on anyone. But then what happened? That understanding that can be taken from the hadith, the scholars, they all unanimously, this is an ijma'ah, unanimously, there's no khilaf, that connecting the sighting of the moon fi haqqi kulli ahadin, on every single person, there is an ijma' ala adam al-ta'liq, that the sighting of the moon cannot be put on every single person. There's an ijma', there's no khilaf on it. And the ijma' of the ulama is a what? It's a hujjah. So the first part of the hadith, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ, if you see it, فَصُومُوا. Are you with me? That's good. The scholars, they unanimously agreed upon. إِجْمَاعُ الْأُمَّةِ عَلَىٰ عَدَمِ تَعْلِيقِ وُجُوبِ الصَّوْمِ بِالرُّؤْيَةِ فِي حَقِّ كُلِّ أَحَدٍ. So what's the meaning going to be then? The meaning is going to be then, إِذَا وُجِدَتِ الرُّؤْيَةِ الشَّرْعِيَةِ, if the correct Islamic observation happens between you guys. Between you guys. And the scholars, they differ on how many people does it have to be. The jumhur, the majority of the scholars are upon the opinion of that it's what? That it's one. There are also those who see it to be two. So there's two opinions here. Some say one, some say two. The ones who said one, they took a hadith which are going to come to us later, inshallah ta'ala, hadith of Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Others, they took it as two, as though it is witnessed. Shahidai adlin. When a witnessing has to be done by a testimony in a court of law, they said it's like a shahada, and a shahada requires two reliable, honest people. إذا رأيتموه. So we explain the word إذا رأيتموه صح. إذا رأيتموه, we've agreed. The ijma' is munaqid. And also there's an athar, there's a hadith of Ibn Umar that's going to come to us later, that's going to explain to us that the Prophet ﷺ only took the sighting of who? Ibn Umar alone. So there's an ijma' and there's the statement of Ibn Umar. That everybody doesn't have to see, everybody doesn't have to see it. Now the part, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ, we said that it's not everybody. But then it says, فَصُومُ. Again, there's a plural in the word فَصُومُ, which is the, is a فعل شرط. So here, does it mean فَصُومُ, that every single person, do you, I want you guys to understand the point. There's two opinions of the sighting of the moon. How many opinions are there?
Two.
What are the two opinions? Either one or two. So there's ijma' that everybody doesn't have to see it. Are you with me? Now, the hadith, other part, what about the other part which says, فَصُومُوا, all of you fast. So it means that if one person sights it, everybody has to fast around the world. If two people see it, then everybody in the world has to fast it. Based on that part. This is where the khilaf came from, which is فَصُومُوا هَذَا مِنْ جِهَةِ فِعْلِ الشَّرْطِ فَالْعُمُومُ فِيهِ غَيْرَ مُرَادٍ بِالْإِجْمَاعِ. Everybody has to fast. So the meaning is going to be أَنَّهُ مَتَى ثَبَتَتِ الرُّؤْيَةُ بِبَلَدٍ. Whenever a seeing takes place in a land, لَزِمَ النَّاسُ, all of the people is obligatory on them. كُلِّهِمْ, all of them. فِي جَمِعِ الْأَقْطَارِ الْأَرْضِ, in all over the world, all over the globe, they have to fast based on that one sighting of one person. Or two people, whichever view you take. Whether the regions are different. سَوَاءً اتَّفَقَتِ الْمَطَالِعُ أَوْ اِخْتَلَفَتْ. مَطَالِعُ here is what? Whether the moon, there's some countries which the day and the night don't happen the same time for them. When it's day for us, it's night for another place in the world, Australia, America. There we have اختلاف المطالع. The moon is not for us all. Where are other countries, the moon is for us. So based on that hadith, فصومو, it doesn't consider مطالع, or you know, whether the مطالع is the same or whether the مطالع is different, it doesn't take that into consideration. Whether the land is close to one another, سواء تباعدت البلدان أو تقاربت, or if it's close to one another, فلو رؤيا, if it was seen, في أقصى الغرب لزم أهل الشرق, if it's seen from the corner of the world down there and from the other side of the world, if it's sighted, then the people from that side have to fast based on the sighting of these people. Does not care whether the land are close to each other or whether the lands are far from one another. And it also doesn't take into consideration whether the matali' is the same or the matali' is different, which is the moon being from the for the same. Then the scholars here, they differed. They differed on it. An ikhtilaf occurred في هذه المسألة, and two strong views have come into place. القول الأول, the first view, وهو مذهب الجمهور, and it's the opinion of the majority of the scholars. From who? الأئمة الثلاثة, أبو حنيفة, إمام مالك, إمام أحمد, وهو قول للشافعي, and it's also the قول of إمام الشافعي, one of his قولs. So what do we have? أبو حنيفة, إمام مالك, and إمام أحمد. And of course, a قول of إمام الشافعي رحمه الله. That, أن الهلال إذا رؤي, if the moon is sighted, في بلد, in a land, لازم الصوم جميع المسلمين في أقطار الأرض, that the Muslims, in wherever they are, all of them have to fast based upon that citation, based upon that seeing that took place. Based on what's the evidence? عَمَلًا بِظَاهِرِ هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ. They based upon how he explains hadith. Are you with me? And they said that this hadith is for خِطَابُ لِلْمُسْلِمِينَ عَامَّةِ, that this hadith is talking to all of the Muslims. فَلَا عِبْرَةَ بِاتِّفَاقِ الْمَطَالِعُ وَاِخْتِلَافِهَا. And they said there is no consideration whether the matali' is the same or whether it's different. And that is the opinion that was strengthened by Samahat al-Walid al-Shaykh Abdul Aziz ibn Abdullah ibn Baz rahimahullah ta'ala. He took that view. هذا ما رجحه الشيخ. The Shaykh strengthened that view. That's the first view. The second view is وهو مذهب الشافعية. It is the مذهب الشافعية. The Shafi'i مذهب. وقول لإمام أحمد. And it's also a call of Imam Ahmed. وهو واختيار الشيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية. And it's also the opinion that Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah took. Which is what? أَنَّ لِكُلِّ بَلَدٍ رُؤْيَتُهُمْ. That every single land has its own seeing. فَإِذَا رُؤِيَ الْهِلَالُ. If the hilal, the moon, is sighted in a land, then it's not obligatory on the other land who is far from it. And they said that this hadith only applies when there is ittifaqul matali', then if the countries they have the same moon, then they have to fast based on each other. وَمَنْ اِخْتَلَفَتْ. As for if the matali', the moon is not shared by them, فَلَا. No. You know what I mean by that, right? That both countries don't share the sighting of that moon. They don't have the moon at the same time. Then they said, this at this point, فَلَا. No. And they have a very strong view. These قول. They have a very strong view. That refutes the first opinion. Their hujjah is the hadith narrated by الإمام البخاري الإمام مسلم رحمه الله الإمام مسلم إمام مسلم رحمه الله. As we know, Imam al-Nawawi is the one who chapters Imam Muslim Sahih. Who chapters it for him? Imam Nawawi chapters it for him. Imam al-Nawawi chaptered for him a chapter in Sahih Muslim, بابو بيان أن لكل بلد رؤيتهم وأنهم إذا رأوا الهلال ببلد لا يثبت حكمه لما بعد عنهم. Which in English is, each land has its own sighting of the moon, and if they see the crescent in one land, that does not necessarily apply to the regions that are far away from it. When Imam Muslim chaptered that chapter in, he brought the narration of who? He brought this, Imam Muslim rahimahullah ta'ala, he brought حدثنا يحيى بن يحيى ويحيى بن أيوب وقتيبة وابن حجر عن يحيى بن يحيى أخبرنا وقال الآخرون حدثنا إسماعيل وهو ابن جعفر عن محمد وهو ابن أبي حرملة عن كريب. كريب is a مولى of who? He's a مولى of Ibn Abbas. He's a مولى of Ibn Abbas. Pay attention to this. أن أم الفضل بنت الحارث بعثته إلى معاوية بالشام. قال فقدمت الشام فقضيت حاجتها واستهل علي رمضان وأنا بالشام فرأيت الهلال ليلة الجمعة ثم قدمت المدينة في آخر الشهر فسألني عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما ثم ذكر الهلال فقال متى رأيتم الهلال؟ فقلت رأيناه ليلة الجمعة فقال أنت رأيته؟ أأنت رأيته؟ فقلت نعم ورآه الناس وصام معاوية فقال لكننا رأيناه ليلة السبت فلا نزال نصوم حتى نكمل 30 أو نراه فقلت أولا تكتفي برؤية معاوية وصيامه فقال لا هكذا أمرنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وشك يحيى بن يحيى في نكتفي أو تكتفي. The hadith is that Quraib Mawla ibn Abbas, he said that Anna Ummul Fadl bint al-Harith, Quraib reported that Umm Fadl, who is the daughter of Al-Harith, she sent him, she sent her own son, which is Fadl bint Al-Harith. She sent Al-Fadl to Muawiyah in Syria, in Syria, Sham, and he was in Dimashq. So he said, فَقَدِمْتُ Sham. I, Fadl, arrived in Syria. I arrived in Sham and did the needful for her. I did what my mother needed from her. فَقَدِمْتُ Sham, فَقَضَيْتُ حَاجَتَهَا. I did what my mother wanted from me. He said, whilst I was there, that the month of Ramadan, it commenced. And I saw the new moon of Ramadan on Friday. I then came back to Medina at the end of the month. And Abdullah ibn Abbas, may Allah be pleased with him, asked me about the new moon of Ramadan. And he said to me, when did you see it? Or he said to me, when did you see the moon? I said, we saw it on the night of Friday. He said, did you see it yourself? I said, yes. And the people also saw it, and they fasted, and Muawiyah also fasted. Whereupon he said, but we saw it on Saturday night. So we all continue to fast till we complete 30 fasts. Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he's saying here, Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he's saying that, did you see it personally? He's asking him. And he said, na'am, I saw it. And the people saw it with me, and they fasted, and so did Muawiyah. Ibn Abbas then said to him, لكننا رأيناه ليلة السبت. But we saw it on Saturday. So we will continue to fast till we complete 30 fasts. حتى نكمل 30. أو نراه, or unless we see it. فقلت, الفضل is saying, I said to him, ألا تكتفي برؤية معاوية? Are you not going to be sufficed with the sighting of Muawiyah and his fasting? فقال لا. Ibn Abbas said, no. هكذا أمرنا رسول الله. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is how the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has commanded us. So based on this hadith, what do we realize? Al-Imam al-Nawawi explains it. He said, hadith Quraib and Ibn Abbas, ظاهر الدلالة للترجمة. It's clear for how the chaptering was placed by him, by Imam Nawawi. He's trying to say it's clear with the chaptering, which is that إنما لم يعمل ابن عباس بخبر قريب ورده لأن الرؤية لا يثبت حكمها في حق البعيد. The reason is because that the sighting is not established on the individual who's far from you. Also, the hadith that we're on right now actually strengthens that opinion, which is that it could be understood in the second view or the second scholar's their opinion, which is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِذَا رَأَيْتُمُوهُ فَصُومُوا. If you guys of every land see it, then fast. Because another people of another land didn't see it. So this addressing is not referring to them. So that is, and this is the opinion that Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah strengthened. Shaykh ibn Uthaymiyyah rahimahullah, he strengthened that opinion, and I advise each and every one of you to read his Sharh al-Mumti', which is the Sharh of Zad al-Mustaqni'. I advise you to go and read Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen. He has a very good statement and a very solid explanation. And he says, وَهَذَا الْقَوْلِ الَّذِي دَلَّ عَلَيْهِ الدَّلِيلِ أَمَا دَلَّ عَلَيْهِ الْأَدِلَّةِ. That second opinion is what the evidences has strengthened. If you want to look more into this issue and you want to research it a bit more, then go to Al-Majmu' of Imam An-Nawawi, the 6th volume, page 274. Go to Al-Mughni Ibn Qudama, 4th volume, page 328. Go to Fath al-Bari, 4th volume, page 123. Go to Ar-Rawdh al-Murbi', 4th volume, page 273. Also with the Hashiya of Ibn Qasim, you can see 3rd volume. Huh? 3rd volume, 358. Hashiya Ibn Abidin, 2nd volume, page 393. Go to the Majmu' of Al-Sheikh Abdul Aziz ibn Baz, the 15th volume, page 77. The Sharh al-Mumta' by Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen, the 6th volume, page 321. Also, go to the Tawdih al-Ahkam by Ibn Bassam, the 3rd volume, 140. Go to the Al-Insaf by Imam al-Mardawi, the 3rd volume, page 273. Go to the Kitab Al-Minah al-Shafiyat fi Sharh al-Mufradat by Buhuti al-Hanbali, page 111. Those are maraji' and those sources which you can, the masadir, you can go to in order to get more researches regarding this issue. The fourth mas'ala that we can take from this hadith, and we will stop that for today inshallah ta'ala, we'll carry on tomorrow by mentioning the fourth benefit that can be taken, among the fourth mas'ala and fiqh that can be taken from this hadith, and the fifth inshallah ta'ala, we will mention that next lesson, and I'll conclude there for now. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.